the converter more valuable.
Most people have never seen a catalytic converter, and it's really not much to look at. But this piece of equipment can cause a big headache.
I ask them, where did you get this? And you really have to rely on your intuition.
Armin Ratty has spent his life running a salvage business in Colchester. In that time, he's bought a lot of converters. He says knowing if they're stolen or not is
virtually impossible. You know, it's not like a vehicle. Somebody brings a vehicle down, you have to have a title. But there's no serial numbers. There's nothing to identify a catalytic converter on a vehicle.
Thanks to a state police crackdown, though, Ratty is the one who could be targeted. Officials say they plan to enforce a law that requires scrap metal buyers to record the information of anyone who sells to them. It comes in the wake of an increasingly popular crime. Just this week, police caught a man underneath a car in South Burlington. His footprints in the snow and the catalytic converter cut halfway out of the car.
We've been plagued by this for about 5 years now. We've had cars singularly be robbed. We've walked in and had 10 cars be robbed.
To handy Toyota owner Dan Luno, any effort can help. He's added night guards and cameras just to protect his business. And for him, it's not just the thieves, but buyers who should beware.
The people that are buying these, in my opinion, that they're as unscrupulous as the people that are stealing them.